hard to see if you've been born and raised here, but when you come from somewhere else, it's so obvious. The abundance in this country, out of control. So much stuff, every day, new stuff. It's like Christmas, every day. Hyperloops, electric cars, SpaceX, robot vacuums, iPhone 8s and 10s at the same time. Can't even wait in America. We get the iPhone 8, we're like, you know what? Fuck 8 and fuck 9, 10, let's go. Just skipping iPhone models. There's so much stuff, there's so much food in America, there's so much food every... Food, so much, there's so much content. So much content. Oh my God, so much content on demand. So many screens. The most screens per capita in the world. Every night in America is like a competition to see how many screens we can get between our face and the wall. It's like iPhone, iPad, laptop, TV, and then Apple Watch. That's me. As many screens in a row as I can get in front of my face. I need a screen below my eyes and a screen above my eyes. So when I look down and I look up, I don't miss any of the action. In this Game of Thrones episode that cost $30 million, but for some reason we couldn't figure out how to adjust the contrast, and so everything is dark as fuck.
Delivery is really a combination of my two favorite activities, eating and not moving. Worst part of delivery is getting up and answering the door. Oh, this is a pain in the ass. What am I, the butler? Well, at least I don't have to put on pants. Hand it over. We're getting lazier. It's just a matter of time. Yeah, I want delivery and I'm going to need someone to feed me. No, I'll be in the tub. Yeah, key is under the mat. Chip, chop, chip. Chip, chop, chip. I don't even know what chip, chop, chip is supposed to mean. We want our food fast, too, don't we? That's why we really love those value meals. Just have to say a number. Two! Soon you won't have to speak, it'll just be a noise. All right, I'll supersize it.
Vegan food has K's and apostrophes where they don't belong. They're like, it's chicken, not chicken, it's chicken, it's chicken, it's chicken. So I was making my little vegan chicken nuggets, and I am a vegan, okay, before you have to, I'm a vegan, right? Except for eggs, sometimes Kraft ranch dressing, and sometimes a rib or two. Okay, maybe I am not a vegan, but the important thing is I identify as a vegan. Okay, I'm like the Rachel Dolezal of veganism, all right? So I was making my little vegan chicken nuggets, and I wanted some ranch, so I hopped onto Postmates, and I ordered my ranch, and I was waiting for it to come to my door. Ding dong, it comes. I open the door, and there's just a loose bottle of ranch. No bag, no nothing. I mean, for $20, you could at least give me a bag or tickle my clit, you know? Imagine there's a bag like tip or tickle. And I couldn't help but think about it from the Postmates perspective, you know? They're working through the pandemic. They're like, I am delivering the essentials. I am doing the Lord's work. Beep, bop, boop. One singular bottle of ranch? This bitch wants me to risk my life for some sauce? No, I'm not giving her a bag, no way, no how, no! And what, make her neighbors think she's ordering essentials? No! Fuck that bitch!
So that's what I'm doing now, Postmates. Postmates not that bad. I actually make decent money. It's kind of weird running into people I know. I ran into this dude that just sold a TV show. He was like, hey, Chaunté Wayans. You know, you try to over-explain yourself. I was like, yeah, man, you know I'm out here hustling. Like, you know, just finished touring and shit, you know what I mean? Just had some meetings about to sell some shit, you know? Just doing this to pay off a little bit of debt, you know, have extra money. He was like, oh, cool, my food is getting cold, I gotta go. You better fucking tip me, man.
Amazon Prime every day. Send that shit to my house every day. Never leave your house. In America, never leave your house. Land of the free and land of never leaving your house. No item too trivial. No quantity too small. To be hand delivered into your home like an emperor. Anything. Anything in the world that comes to mind. Any fleeting thought you have while drunk. Anything. I want one pen. I want one. I don't want a box. I want just one pen. I want it in a box with some plastic. Throw some napkins in there. In another box. In a bigger box. More Prime. Can't get enough Prime here. Need it Prime. We need Prime harder, faster, stronger. Faster Prime. Prime now. Prime now. 2-hour delivery. Prime now. Give it to me now. When I press buy, put the item in my hand. Now. In America, there should be no lag. Zero lag. Between when I press the button and when the item is gently placed into my hand. So I can use it now. Same day. Now. Prime now. Break into my house. And put the food I ordered in my mouth. And help me chew it. And then push it down my esophagus with a stick. And then pour the feces out of my anus for me. Now. It's like, where do we go from here? As a civilization, like, how much more convenience can we get? How much less energy can we use to get what we want? Let's get Prime before. Send it to me before I want it. It's 2019, I have to make a decision before you mail me what I buy. Use artificial intelligence to substitute my own intelligence so I can live my life. Send me everything I want before I want it in as many boxes as possible. So much packaging.
I don't know. But anyways, you know what I'm afraid of? You know I'm afraid of? Robots. Yeah. I saw one get interviewed on 60 Minutes, the top journalistic program in the United States. And he's just sitting there getting interviewed, not nervous at all, just rattling off all the fucking answers, you know? Not smoking, not fucking, you know, leaking oil, whatever you would do as a nervous robot, right? And the reporter's asking him questions, and in the end he goes, so tell us, he's like, what are your goals? And I am alone in a hotel room. And I literally lean towards the TV. I'm like, these fucking things have goals? And the fucking robot just answers. He just goes, what are your goals? And the robot goes, to become smarter than human beings. Yeah. And the reporter just blows by it. He's like, okay, and what's your favorite color? Meanwhile, I'm standing on my bed yelling at the TV like, dude, unplug that fucking thing. Take the batteries out. Pull the wires out, do something! How many sci-fi movies do you have to see before you realize where this is going? So anyway, is, every smart person, every super smart person in the world is saying these fucking things are gonna kill us. Even your boy here, the guy who he recently died, what was his name? He was always sitting down. Hawkins, Stephen Hawkins, yeah. Too good to fucking stand up and make his point, just sitting down all fucking smarmy. I poured ice on myself. And I showed off my abs at the same time for the gram.
You know what's fucked up? We use our fingerprint now. We won't even trust our own codes. We willing to give our information to the government. Riding your girl, get your shit. And she trying to get that shit. She trying to get that shit. You sleep, you feel your hand moving? Bitch, you know about that hand. I wanted to cuddle. You ain't want to cuddle, bitch. You have my index finger extended. I can't trust you.
You can trust me.
Hell, fuck no. Now I got to sleep with oven mitts on around this motherfucker. I got to sleep with boxing gloves on. Bitch, I can't trust you.
This nigga didn't put on boxing gloves, bitch. What should I do?
I know it's our fault, though. It's our fault. We always get the fucking wandering. That phone, that technology gets you to wandering. IG, bitch, is bad. God damn. God damn. How many times can I like this same picture? Niggas be willing to break their finger on the picture. God damn. Oh, this picture is amazing. Twitter gotta follow Snapchat. Who this bitch here? Ooh, look at this bitch. Any new technology, man, fuck with it. That waterproof phone came out, nigga. Like the waterproof phone? Men was immediately in the shower talking to the bitches. Hello, other hoes. Yeah, I ain't gotta leave my phone out there no more. Yeah, what I'm doing in here, watching my balls, getting ready for your jaws, bitch. Yes. I know how it is. What I'm doing, what I do for you. Niggas was macking other bitches underwater. I'm single. Crazy black girl come looking for your ass. Who the fuck are you talking to? Who the fuck are you talking to? You can't swim. I'm gonna kill. You gonna drown. I'm gonna kill.
We trust our phones too much. Could you imagine 20 years ago, a foreign guy pulling up in a sedan telling you, get in. You'd be like, get the fuck out of here. Not today. You're like, are you gagak? Photo doesn't really look like you, but I think this is the vehicle. Strange. And Uber is expanding into a lot of different areas. You don't have this yet here in New York City, but in Los Angeles, they have a thing called Uber Kitten, where they'll bring a cat to your house for 1 hour. Why would you do that? I've never been sitting around my home and asked my wife, babe, call Uber, let's get a cat over here for 1 hour. I need to pet something. World is changing, and I don't know if it's for the better. A lot of technologies out there. I'm not into it, right? Craigslist is a big, big website. People go there. First of all, have you gone to the Craigslist website? It looks like it came out when the internet came out. Does anybody want to put up some flash? Looks like Braille, I don't know. But people sell stuff on this with no problem. I don't know. I can't do this. It's weird. This Craigslist, it's, you don't know who's coming to your house, right? It's like an invitation to get murdered. Just put on the posting, you know, area rug for sale, come murder me and my family. You don't know what you're getting. We used to have a garage sale. That's how we did it. We just threw the garbage on a Saturday morning. We just threw it out on the driveway. We put some signs all over town with an arrow, come get our garbage. And the weirdest people would show up to your home. You would have like a table with a cash box in the garage open, but you would just watch people mill around your yard, right? They'd come out of their cars. Someone get a little too close to the house, you're like, back up, back off, back off. What do you want? Tell me right from there what you want. Can we use your bathroom? Bathroom? Get the hell off my property. It's not Walmart's a shit sale. Pick what you need and leave. And whatever we didn't sell, we threw it out. But we broke it before we threw it in the garbage. That's my father. He's like, if they're not gonna buy it at my sale, they're not gonna come by later on tonight and steal it out of my garbage. Saw the couch in half. 12 years old, I'm sawing. Right? He's like, burn all the lamps, burn all these lamps, pop the eyeballs out of the teddy bear, and then decapitate the head. You throw the head out on Tuesday and then the body out on Saturday. I know who was looking at this bear, and when they come back and find out there's no eyeballs or no body, they're not gonna want a head.
And this is when I really learned the lesson, you can't be too high, right? So I was too high one day and I was on WebMD, right? Yeah, and if you're not familiar, WebMD is just a website for hypochondriacs. It's just an online doctor to help you diagnose yourself with diseases with no medical professionals present, right? It's a horrible idea. And the way it works is that you go there, there's a drawing of a human, you click on whatever part of you hurts, they zoom in, and on the left side of the screen, they give you a list of all the symptoms that part of you could possibly have. And if you click on one of the symptoms, on the other side of the screen, they'll give you 5,000 diseases that you might have. And if you click on another symptom, that 5,000 go down to 2,500. Another symptom, it go down to 1,000, right? But here's the bullshit. You will never get it down to one. You can click every symptom in that list, and you will never get it down to one. You'll end up with at least 3 diseases. And maybe you're familiar with a couple, but at least one of them's gonna scare the shit out of you. Okay? So everybody knows what weed does. Everybody knows what WebMD is, right? Here's my story. I'm too high. I'm on this website. My throat hurts. I click on neck. I'm scrolling through the neck symptoms. And one of the symptoms is short, wide neck. Yeah. You may have noticed I have a short, wide neck. I've always had a bigger than usual head since my grandma threw me against the wall. And my neck has just grown thicker to keep it stable, right? So I'm just curious, what the fuck disease is that a symptom for? So I clicked on it. And this was my first time ever using WebMD. I clicked on one symptom. I got one disease. It was Down syndrome. Yeah. And like I said, under normal circumstances, I'd be fairly certain that I don't have Down syndrome, right? I was very high. And so my first thought was, Brian, that is ridiculous. You don't have Down syndrome. Someone would have said something by now. But my next thought was, unless part of having Down syndrome is believing you don't have Down syndrome. Right? Like, Like, what if this is just a delusion that I'm a real comedian on Netflix? But what's happening in reality is I'm just standing on the table at my Make-A-Wish benefit, you know? Y'all are just cheering for me because I'm retarded and I'm trying my hardest. And, oh no, he is so brave. Look at him. Going after it.
Actually, now that I think about it, I'm surprised that we still have sex. That's a crazy thing. When you think about it, that people still have sex, that's odd. Because we factored people out of every part of our lives. When you think about it, you don't even need people to meet people anymore. You can use your phone to meet people. You know? And whenever you want food or something, you don't even have to know who cooked it. You just order on your phone, and then some guy brings it. That's not the guy who cooked it, and you don't talk to him either. You just grab the bag and close the door. Like, you don't want him in your life either. But we still have sex. It's the most intimate thing that you can do with another person, and even that's about to be over. Sex is almost over. Because as soon as they invent like a vibrator that really listens. You know what I mean? Like, as soon as it's just like a ninth setting on a jackrabbit that's like, vroom, 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 they don't deserve you at work. Vroom, like, what are we gonna do? And likewise, once they just make porn that says it's proud of you, do you know how many men will die next to the computer? Like, how did Joe die? Happy. Like, it's crazy.
Well, listen, I agreed with all of these super smart people thinking that these fucking robots were gonna kill us, right? I agreed with all of that shit until a couple of years ago, I was in New York and I was looking through a newspaper, right? And I have a whole new fucking theory. But in order for me to tell you my theory, I have to quickly take you back to the deep, dark, sordid history of the blow-up doll. I know there's a lot of millennials here, young people. You probably don't even know what one of these is, all right? With your fucking, I don't know what you guys do, your virtual reality glasses, you know, fucking free porn flying by you, grabbing titties, and whatever it is you do, all right? Back in the day, this was the deal. If you were a person and you wanted to have sex with somebody else, but like nobody else wanted to have sex with you, you had to go, you had, this is how it was. You had to go out and you had to get a blow up doll and you had to fucking go out and get it. You had to fucking go out and get it, right? You couldn't just order it off of an Amazon and some delivery guy shows up. He doesn't know what's in the box. You're standing there like Tom Hanks. Hey, how you doing? Great to see you. I'm gonna fuck that. You have no idea what it is. Now, dude, you had to go down and you had to fucking get this thing. You had to find a porno store, you had to work it out that was far enough away from your house that no one's gonna recognize your car. You drive down at like 11 in the morning, who the fuck is gonna be there then, right? You park in the back on like a Tuesday, just sitting there in the car, psyching yourself up, like, okay, I'm not hurting anybody, it's just an urge, just get in there, okay? Hand in the money, just get in there and get it done. You yank your hat down, you walk in with all your courage. And then you get in there and be too many other perverts in there and you get all psyched out. So what you do is you just grab a bunch of videotapes and you walked up to the counter and you had to make it look like it was an impulse buy, right? And you're walking up and everything, all the creepy shit was behind the counter, right? Just fucking heads and feet, just an ass, body parts, serial killer buffet. What fucking world am I entering? Oh my God, somebody's fucking a neck, Jesus Christ, right? And you set it down. Just make it look real subtle. Okay, buddy, is that gonna be all? Maybe that thing down the end with the surprise look on its face? Maybe I'd like to take a shot at that. I don't know. The guy wraps it up and then you finally get it, you give him the money, you fucking run out to the car, you have this whole weird emotion. You're like excited and you hate yourself. Thank God I finally did it! What the fuck is wrong with me? Just drive off. You go back to your little shitty fucking apartment and you had to blow it up quietly. So none of your neighbors heard, just like. Then you got excited, start going a little faster. And just watching this thing slowly come into life, just like. legs around you. And God forbid you got caught. Your roommate comes walking in, he's fucking a blow-up doll! Dude, your life was over. You had like 6 minutes to get your mom on the phone like, Mom, I love you, and you're never gonna see me again. Don't believe what people said about me, I'm so sorry. I'm going to Alaska, oh God, God, click. That was it. So now, fast forward to about 2016, I'm in New York City, right? And I'm looking through the newspaper, whatever, and I come across an article, and it's on this robot that for $10,000, you buy this thing, you can have sex with it, right? Now notice, 5 minutes ago, I brought up a blow-up doll. Didn't even have a joke, just said blow-up doll, and you all laughed. A blow-up doll. Who would do such a stupid thing, right? That's weird. 5 minutes later, I say a robot that you can have sex with, dead silence in here. As if collectively you were all just like, well, what does it look like? I'm not gonna lie to you. It still looks like a dead body, but it looks way fucking better than that blow-up doll from 30 years ago. And that's what scares me, because everything gets better, right? You look at when cars first came out, the stupid horn, ah-ooga, you had a crank starting, you'd run over your best friend. Now you can start one up with a remote control from like 50 yards away, right? Remember when airbags first came out? They just had one for the driver. My family! Dolls are gonna be no different, okay? They're just gonna keep getting better and better and better. And these fucking nerds are not gonna be making any regular-looking robot dolls, right? You know, some girl next door, you know, just some plain Jane, the chick your mom likes, being like, well, there's a nice girl you can settle down with. She knows how to cook. Fuck that. They're gonna make Victoria's Secret supermodels, just absolute, like Paris runway-looking supermodels. And you're gonna be able to come home to one of these things, and it's gonna laugh at all your jokes. It's gonna sit down and watch the game with you like, it doesn't get any better than this. Yes, it does. And it's gonna get up and make you a fucking, I don't know, bundt cake or a meat pie, whatever the fuck you people eat, right? There's not gonna be a human woman in here that's gonna be able to compete with that for longer than 90 minutes, even on your birthday. By the third trip to the fridge, she's gonna be like, yeah, fucking get it yourself. What am I, your slave? Go fuck yourself. And after you've been with one of these robots, like sex dolls, this, you're not gonna be able to go back to a real woman, right? With all her hopes and dreams and her needs. You're gonna be coming home, she's like, what is going on with you? We're not connecting, we need a date night. All you'll be thinking is like, how do I shut this fucking thing off? What is it, on nagging mode? Why isn't it blowing me right now? I clearly entered the room. I entered the room, it's supposed to drop to its knees and blow me. I don't understand. Yeah, like your ego is gonna be at like a dictator level. Like me and my man tits have arrived. Service me. Say that I am your lord. Yeah, that's it. That's it. You're not gonna be able to go back to a real woman. And then nobody's gonna be fucking women, so they're gonna get lonely, so they're gonna have to create a doll for you guys, right? A giant fucking, I don't know what you guys are into. I don't pretend to know, like some giant Brad Pitt looking fucking robot doll, fucking 8-pack abs, a robot dick down to the floor, you know? Holds both your hands when you tell a story, right? Well, whatever you're into. Opens a bottle of wine at 12 noon. It's got to be 5 o'clock somewhere. Yeah. I think they're gonna fuck us into extinction. Because at that point, the only people left having sex with other human beings are gonna be hipsters and the homeless, right? Because hipsters, they love all the old shit, right? Cassette tapes, frisbees, dressing like a cobbler, whatever the fuck it is they're doing, right? But even a homeless guy, you know, after like, I don't know, a couple of years, he'll be able to drag some old, one-legged, fucked-out robot model out of the trash, drag it back to its lair, and even... That thing will still be building them up, you know, just laying there like, I don't think you smell that bad. This is my favorite bridge. We're all gonna fucking die off, and what's gonna be left to fight these robots off is gonna be an entire generation of hipster spawn. Yeah, and they're gonna go to war ironically. Yeah, dressed like, I don't know, fucking growing Civil War beards, dressing like Star Wars action figures, and they're gonna get fucking slaughtered. And right when they get down to the last 30, there's gonna be some liberal robot going like, we should save a few for posterity. Right? And they're just gonna stick them in a zoo and be this little hodgepodge of what was left. You know, black, white, Latin, Asian, gay, straight, trans, whatever. Whatever the fuck, right? And they're still gonna be arguing with each other. The robots are just be standing outside going, I love it when they cross their legs.